Welcome back students. Once again I am here with the classification of introduction. In the previous module we have been already discussed all important points regarding to the reproduction, its means sexual and asexual reproduction. Now we are just going to discuss about the complete classification of reproduction. So students, firstly the reproduction can be classified into two. Already you are doing first one, that is asexual reproduction, and second one, that is sexual reproduction. Characteristic feature we have been already discussed. So let us come first to the asexual reproduction. In asexual mode of reproduction, the first sub mode is cell division. Means in this process any cellular body, it's maybe any kind of living organism, its cell get divided. Okay, so in cell division there are three conditions. First condition, that is fission. It is very common by the two ways, binary fission and multiple fission. Then the second subdivision of cell division, budding, which is very common in yeast and hydra. Then the third subdivision, that is sporulation. Sporulation means the formation of spores. Okay, in this situation the spores body get produces, like in rhizopus the fungal body is called mycelium. The mycelium will contains the large number of spores which are filled inside this body, and when they get mature they dispose, and when they get the favorable condition, get germinate to become new individual body. Once again we are just going to discuss about the fission. Fission is two type, binary fission and multiple fission. The binary fission, it is possible by the three ways. Irregular binary fission, which is very common in amoeba. Irregular binary fission, it is common in amoeba. And third, that is second, that is transverse binary fission, which is common in bacteria. Then the last kind of binary fission, longitudinal binary fission, it is common in Molina. This means that the binary fission, it is possible by the three ways, means irregular, then transverse, then longitudinal. Then the second type of fission, that is multiple fission, which is very common, in Plasmodium. Okay, in Plasmodium it is common, is multiple fission. Then let us come to the second sub classification of asexual mode of reproduction, that is fragmentation. Fragmentation means the individual body, organism's body, get breaks into small fragments, and each fragment will become a new individual body. Okay, so fragmentation, it is common in Spirogyra. Okay, then the third subclassification of asexual reproduction, that is planaria. In planaria, suppose one planaria is there, if it is break down into small pieces, means 2, 3, 4 pieces, each piece becomes the new individual body. Means reproduction, it is common in planaria. Now we will discuss about some special structures. These special structures may be conidia and genules. Conidia means in penicillium, which is the best example of fungal categories. In this category, this type of structures get produces, which will contains the small spores. Then the second special structure, that is genule. The genule get produces in sponge. Okay, it will produces in sponge. The sponge will forms this type of body, and this body will contain the small sizes of spores. Then these spores become mature, they get dispersed to outside, and each spores get germinate to become new individual organisms. Then the last and important asexual sexual classification, that is the vegetative reproduction, vegetative propagation. So before going to the vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation, we would like to discuss about what is vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation means when any kind of vegetative part of plant, either stem or leaf or root, having capability to produce the new organism's body. So the vegetative part will involve for this process. In this type of classification, the first one, that is underground stem, means the stem will be underground, it is not exposed to outside. Okay, so underground stem having three conditions are growing. In previous class we have already discussed about this. So the first structure, that is the tuber, second, that is rhizome, then third one, that is bulb. Tuber, it is common in potato, rhizome, it is common in ginger, and bulb, which is common in onion. These all three are the example of underground stem. Let us come to the next, second type of vegetative part, that is subaerial stem condition. Means partial outside and partial underground. Two examples are here, runner and sucker. So what is the example of runner? You also keep in mind, runner is also called stolon. Runner is also called stolon. Okay, so the example of runner, that is strawberry. Then the second, sucker. So what is the example of sucker? Mint. Mint is the best example of sucker. Let us come to the third condition, aerial stem. It will be totally aerial. And what is the example of aerial stem? Ajale. It is the good example of aerial stem. Now the second important vegetative part of plant, that is leaf of bryophyllum. As you all are going about to bryophyllum, the leaf of bryophyllum having small buds, and these small buds will become to produce the new organisms. Okay, then the next one, root of water hyacinth and root of pistia, these both having the capability to produce the new organisms. Okay.